Hi, it's Corey with Martin Deerline Product Support. Today we're going to run through the 1910 hydraulic drive air cart, the calibration process, and the meter rate verification process. So we're going to start in the cab with all the setup, and then we're going to go out to the tank through the process.
Okay, to start the calibration process here, the setup of it, I'm going to go into my setup of the meters. And then I want to calibrate on this cart today. We're going to calibrate the middle tank on this one. So I'm going to change it to the middle tank. And I'm going to select my product. I already have wheat in there, hard red spring wheat. I'm going to put my rate in here. Today we're going to be seeding 150 pounds. So I'm going to put my rate in here. And we want to make sure we have the right meter roller in there, right color. Select from the drop down. Today we're going to be using the green roller. Now we're ready to start the calibration process. We hit the cal button at the top, and because we're only going to do the middle tank today, I'm just going to select the middle tank. If we were filling all three tanks, we can do all three tanks together at once. We just have to make sure we check the other two boxes. Now I'm going to hit the calibration button, and it's going to tell me to install my calibration bag and charge my meter. So basically, when we started, we've loaded a new tank. Our meters are not charged with any product yet, so we need to make sure that the meters are totally charged with product so we get an accurate calibration. So now we're going to go outside and show you how we charge the calibration bag. Okay, so in order to charge our meter, we're going to install our calibration bag first to catch the product. I'm going to install it on the bottom meter housing. I've got my bottom plate removed and on the ground. Install the bag on the four tabs, tighten the strap up, make sure we haven't got any leakage here, we're not going to lose any product. The other thing is to make sure our double shoot slide is pushed all the way in, showing where we're going to be on the calibration side of the double shoot slide. Now I'm going to come over to the calibration switch. I'm going to hold the calibration switch down now, and I'm applying product into the bag. Let it spin for probably 4 or 5 revolutions. You can hear the product in the bag, so now our meter is charged. Now I'm going to remove the bag. I'm going to dump the product back into a pail so we can take it back up and dump it back in the tank. Okay, now that we've charged our meters at the back, we've caught our product in the bag, we dumped it in the pail, we put our empty bag back on. We come back into the tractor cab now here, and we hit our calibration button. Now we are ready for a full calibration. Now we can come back to our calibration switch. We're going to hold the calibration switch down. Our meter is going to rotate and start filling the bag, and we're going to keep holding the meter switch down, the calibration switch down, until the meter stops turning. We're going to take a few revolutions here. Another important thing to make sure is that we're in pounds. The other mode is in kilograms. Make sure we're in pounds. Now we can weigh our product in the bag. Okay, as you can see here, we have 33.42. We need to make sure we take the weight of the bag off here. These calibration bags weigh 1 pound. So the number I'm going to take to the cab now is 32.4 and enter it into the display. Okay, so now we're back in the tractor cab. We want to enter our weight into the middle tank. We can see we've done our calibration. We have 12 revolutions of the meter. Now I'm going to enter my weight, 32.4 pounds. Enter, and then we hit our final enter key. Our new meter displacement value is listed there now. You can do a couple more calibrations just to make sure the calibration is coming and this number does not change very much. But in most likely cases, your calibration is ready to go. The last thing we're going to do here now is we're going to do a meter rate verification to check and make sure our rates are coming out properly. Now that we've completed the calibration process, we're going to go into the meter rate verification, checking to make sure our rates are coming out accurately. We go into our totals tab and then our calculations tab. Here we have a meter rate meter verification. Because we did the middle tank, we make sure we check the middle tank. And today we're going to do a stationary check, so we check that box too. Down here we check to make sure we have, we're going to check for a tenth of an acre, so we're going to take our weight, whatever weight comes out, multiply it by 10 to get our actual pounds per acre. Okay, now we're back out here at the air cart to get on the toggle switch now to check our meter rate verification. So I'm going to hit the toggle switch and hold it down. The meter starts turning, and if it stops turning, we get to a tenth of an acre away. So. Now I'm going to remove the bag and weigh it. Again, our scale is turned on. Make sure it's zeroed. We're on pounds. And now we can check the weight of the bag. There we go. We got 16.25. If we minus 1 pound for the bag, we're at 15.25, so we're at 152 pounds. So very close to where we need to be. If we're really fussy, we could go back in and do one more calibration to try and bring that number in a lot closer. At least we know where we're at when we go to the field now to go seeding that we're close to our 150 pounds an acre. And that concludes our meter rate verification.